to them today willingly, going to line up or drive in their car and queue up for a invasive swab up their nose. So,
if you're even remotely inclined,
we've got Graham Lyons here, and we all know he's in the magistrate's court for his refusal to comply. So, if you need any tips or tricks, we're all here. We have to practice your disobedience. We have to push back on this in every way we can, because we do not comply, we do not agree, we do not buy into this hoax, do we? And we know that very obviously, with all the alarm that's been generated by the moronic strain, people coming from interstate borders, opening exposure sites, lining up at the testing clinics where a flawed test gives false positives, and we hear about increasing case numbers when nobody's actually sick, are they? No. There's two people in hospital apparently, probably against their will. I'd suspect they're being held captive, but it's a pretty pathetic number when people are losing jobs because of mandates for a jab that is not a vaccine, that makes no claim at stopping any form of infection and is actually spreading a whole lot of disaster. So, we do not comply. This is not a super spreader event, so that's the end of the first disclaimer. That's a load of crock. Don't know who spread that. The advertiser tried to paint us as some sort of, I'm not sure actually if we're far right, extreme right or extreme left. Anyone happy to fill me in on that? The messaging is it's pretty obscure. All I've come to the conclusion is like that the advertiser and the ABC are very intimately aligned with these extremist groups because they're all on the same page trying to intimidate people into not having a voice. So I'm glad to see all of you beautiful people are not buying into that intimidation. Thank you for coming today. We're going to have a great day. I will begin by acknowledging that we stand here on Kaurna land, and I pay my respects to the spiritual people whose land this is, to their elders past, present and emerging. We would have seen during the week that finding a fragment of a fake virus in the water in APY lands meant they put caps on the amount of money they could access or fuel they could purchase. So I just want a show of hands, you know, when they find something here in metropolitan Adelaide, how would you all feel if someone told you how much money you could spend or how much fuel you could purchase? They could go to hell, I can hear in the background. I mean, this is a closed community anyway. There's no community more heavily monitored than the people in the APY lands. And yet they do that, so that is just testimony to how far they will reach with our Indigenous First Nations people under the guise of, I don't know, what is it? What is it they're doing to us? I mean, it's not health, it's not protection, it's just control. So we're going to start today with some music. Grace is going to sing a carol And then we've got Grace and Todd together, I believe, to sing I Am Australian. So you can all join in with that one. All right, over to you.
Thanks, Kathy.
Feel free to sing along, wave your hands in the air, get ready to do this rally. She's quite distressed, but otherwise unharmed. We're just setting up for the next tune.
England, France, Greece.
Yep. You want Telegram?
It's on.
I've got WhatsApp. Have you got that?
So this is Ty and Grace. Grace is one of our beautiful volunteers, and Ty you will recognise because he leads our marches. Very, very passionately. He tries. He does good.
Send him in.
Good afternoon, Adelaide!
I nearly said good morning. I'm used to this being in midday, not this late in the afternoon. My name is Typhoon Speed. Thank you so much for coming along today. I think we all know why we're here. We're here to show the people in Parliament House, the people of Adelaide, that we are united, that we're not going to put up with this tyranny, and that we are here to fight back. And we do all this thing because we love each other, and because we are Australian. Let's do this.
No amplifiers. Hello. No to mandatory vaccinations. No teachers losing their jobs because they didn't get a jab. This is Australia. We're a free country.
We're all rushing into this live in Melbourne right now. They've got enough to take off.
Whoa! There's a Pauline Hanson lady.
What, she here? No, she's not.
No, her workers here.
Oh, her workers here? Well, you mean a campaign squad here?
Yeah. She's against all this. Pauline Hanson's all against this.
She won the
All right, this is the best we can do.
Yeah, she was the Prime Minister, though. Whoa!
Okay, that's sort of. Testing, two.
There's no amplifier now.
More in need.
I should have bought my mini amplifier.
Testing, two.
Yeah.
Take one, yep. All right, so clearly you can tell we're having some audio issues. So you know what that means, guys? That means we're going to need all of you, the thousands of you, to help us sing along. Do you guys think you can help us out with that?
I think we can.
All right, let's get this loud. Let's go.
Keeper of the flame.
the one who was Matilda.
You're still a doctor.
The trauma ends, the emergency end. And I never made a bad medical decision that killed the patient in all of those 32 years. They used to pay me $350,000 a year to examine the science and keep people safe. I use my training to make life-critical health decisions every day. And now I'm cancelled for doing exactly that. I examined the science and I concluded that the COVID vaccines are not safe, not effective, and not in the best interests of most people, including myself. And so, I declined to take part in that medical experiment, and for that, I was cancelled. So now, I want you to do something for me. I want anybody in this crowd who's had COVID to stick their hand up. And I mean really had COVID. I don't mean had a false positive PCR following a test that they were forced to take when they weren't even sick. I mean respiratory illness, gone to hospital, lost a week out of your life in bed at home. Is there anyone? Okay, I couldn't see anyone. Maybe there's one. Okay, second question. Has anybody here been harmed by COVID? Stick your hand up. You should all have your hands up. Everybody has been harmed by COVID. But not harmed by the disease COVID. We've all been harmed by the government's attempts to manage COVID. We've all endured endless government-inflicted pain, all in a futile attempt to manage a respiratory virus that for most of us will be nothing more than a cold. Our businesses have suffered and failed. Look at mine.
But they're still getting their wages.
We have lost our jobs. We've lost our friends. We've lost our houses. We've lost the ability to live our lives. Some of us have suffered vaccine injuries and others have been assaulted by the police. Our holidays have been ruined, our travel restricted, our freedoms have been stolen. Some of us have been sent to jail, many hotels, for the crime of association, for the crime of being roughly in the same place at roughly the same time as somebody else who also had a false positive PCR test. Ask Senator Antic, is he still in jail? Senator Antic was arrested and taken to jail for the crime of suspicion of being unvaccinated. And yes, he was arrested and he was taken to jail. When armed police escort you against your will to a secure facility with locks on the doors and keep you there for 14 days, you have been arrested and you have been taken to jail.
Shameful!
We have been made into criminals by our own government. We all now live in a police state, a place where the police commissioner can write his own rules and then sign off on them. A place where your elected politician can send the police around to silence you if you ask too many inconvenient questions about COVID. Ask me how I know.
How do you know?
That's what happened to me. My own MP, who I voted for, forgive me, I knew not what I did. My own MP, Josh Teague, sent the police around to intimidate me rather than answer the questions I sent him about COVID management. That was Josh Teague, Speaker of the House in the Parliament of South Australia. And what punishment did Premier Marshall dole out to the Speaker of the House for this gross misuse of political power. The Premier promoted Josh Teague to the Attorney General's position. Think about that. The top legal officer in the state is a man who thinks it's okay to send the police around to silence political opponents. And what did the police commissioner do? We know that he's aware, because I've seen the letter of complaint that one of you wrote asking him whether this was an appropriate use of police resources. What's the bet we don't hear anything more about that? We now live in a police state where ordinary, decent people are scared of the police. They've seen the thuggery in Victoria and in New South Wales, and we know it's coming here.
Bring it on!
But we've all been right to resist, even at such heavy cost, because COVID vaccines are new, are untested, are dangerous, are experimental, and for most people, are unnecessary. Even the short-term safety data are highly concerning. Miscarriages are happening. Strokes are happening. Heart attacks are happening. Many only a day or two after injection. Myocarditis is real. Did you know they've just added a billing code to Medicare for the management of post-vaccine myocarditis? Did you know that?
No, I did not.
They did that for an extremely rare side effect.
I wouldn't see me because I wasn't vaccinated.
One of my sources at the military base at Edinburgh has told me that six soldiers there have myocarditis after their forced mandatory vaccinations. And just like the athletes we've heard about have found themselves in this position, these are six fit young people whose lives, careers and health are probably ruined. And what of the long-term risks? Infertility, autoimmune disease, acquired immune deficiency, booster addiction, cancer. What about those? What is the risk of those? The true answer is nobody knows. We can't know. No, we haven't had enough time to find out. Most drugs take years or decades to fully approve. These new, untried, untested experimental drugs have been rushed out in a period of months worldwide under coercion. And now they want to extend it to our children. Children have even less risk of serious COVID than even young adults, and they have a lifeline to develop and deal with any side effects that may come up. The US and UK data says that the risk of serious COVID in children is 1 in 1,000,000. Why are we doing this? And the vaccines don't even work.
Why are you doing it?
Ask Barnaby Joyce. Ask Jay Weatherill. Ask yourselves. If two jabs work, why take a third? If two jabs don't work, why take a third?
Here, here.
If the vaccines work, Why aren't they working?
They're not vaccinated. That's why.
Everyone in Australia will be exposed to COVID at some point.
Send them up the arse.
Each of us will have to fight our own personal battle with COVID. My immune system does not protect you, and my children's immune system does not protect their grandparents. And even if it did, what sort of society uses its children as human shields for their grandparents? What sort of society does that? Yes, my friends, we have all been hurt by COVID, many grievously, by the government response, however, not by the virus. Winning this fight is crucial, because losing means tyranny. It means compulsory central planning of your health forever. It means the transformation of our once free country into a medical dictatorship. I will not let this happen. Not to me, not to you, and not to my children. And looking around me, my spirits are high. My spirits are high because I know we will win. When I see so many ordinary, decent citizens standing up against this, I know we will win. I read your banners, I feel your energy, and I hear your voices. We will win because the light of freedom is always stronger than the boot of tyranny. The light of freedom is always stronger than the boot of tyranny. Thank you for coming out with me today.
Thank you!
Nothing in your lives or your children's lives will ever be more important than this. Nothing will ever be more important than this.
Here, here!
Hold the line and thank you.
Thank you!
Hey everybody, this is Mel from Adelaide Freeway, Adelaide Freedom Rally. How are we doing today? It's so good to be here. We are here in unity. We are here to make a message and make a stand for what? Our body autonomy. We want to get excited about things. I know it's a hot one, but have I got any voices in the crowd today? Yeah. Hey, I want to do a quick poll. Kathy just asked me, do we want to do the short march today or the long march today? Hands up for the short. Hands up for the long. All right. Well, let's say poll no. All right, we are Adelaide Freedom Rally, and we want to let you know today that we are in your corner. We stand for body autonomy, for individual freedom and choice, and for liberty. All right, so that's what we're on about. The best way that you can stay connected with us is make sure you subscribe to our email list. Go to our website, adelaidefreedomrally.com. In the top right-hand corner, you'll find the subscribe button. And that is our primary communication tool with you. You will get the information you need about our events, when we're meeting, pop-up rallies, videos that we think are great. We also got secondary sources of information. You've got the Facebook there. We've got some people with the Telegram and stuff like that as well. But if you want it straight from the horse's mouth, you must subscribe to our email list, all right? Today we've got people in the crowd with the iPads and they're trying to help you get connected. If you're not a tech person, go to the gazebo over there, come down the front here and we'll get you signed up on the list. Appreciate that some of you are not all on top of that. We want to make sure you don't miss a message today. All right, speaking of our volunteers who are out in the crowd today, we've got the donations buckets. We've got the crew of these guys here, David's got these buckets all going along. We'd really love it if you could find a tenner or a 20 to help us along the way here. Every time we put on a rally, costs us about $1,200 to $1,500, and that's money that has to come from somewhere. That comes from you and I, right? So look out for the buckets if you can help there. Ideally, one day, we'd like to have a big screen here to make it easier for the people down the back to see us, and that's just, again, more expenses that we need to account for. So if you can help us there, that'd be great. All right, we've got some trailers over here. I've got Luke from Guardians SA. He's going to come up, give him a crowd, big wave here. He's going to talk about donations. Hello, Adelaide, welcome. So good to feel your vibe. Through Safe Guardian South Australia, we found we were limited in what we could do, so we created the Safe organisation. It's a central hub, a place where we can find information and resources and keep updated and connected. It is run by the community. It is run by you and me, by the information that you put onto it for us and for everybody else. One of the initiatives we've done, we keep hearing a call out of what is it we can do? And we hear mandated people are being put into very stressful situations. So we created an initiative today, give what you can, take what you need. And people have been very, very generous. We thank you so much for all the non-perishable food goods and toys you've given. If there are people that are in need today that have been mandated or are in need for Christmas, please go take what you need. This is provided by everybody here to support each other as a community in common unity. I've heard stories of people being turned away at community service organisations. We have called community service organisations that are non-discriminatory, so you can feel safe to go to. That is where these donations will be going to. The list is available on the SAFE website. One of the organisations I spoke with before COVID, before the mandates, were taking 40 to 50 calls a day. Since COVID, 150 to 200 calls a day. Your help is needed. Support each other. Come together in love, peace, and unity. Thank you. You know, the great work of what Luke is doing is about, obviously, so many people affected by settings. And who here is affected by a setting and you can't go to your place of work? Put your hand up. There's nurses, there's teachers, kindy, childcare workers. We feel for you at this time. Do sing out if the mortgage is still coming at you. Find and connect with someone. That's what it's all about, people. It's about connection here. Now, the rally. You know, we can get together and put rallies on, we can do all sorts of things, but the most important thing is that you get connected with someone and that you make a contribution through that connection. All right, I want to give a quick update. Who knows about our JR initiative? Yep, JR initiative. All right, so I've got some notes here. I'm going to read from my notes because they're a little bit technical. I've got the note. The judicial review, I've been told. All right, who knows about our judicial review? All right, so it's a big thing. It's a big thing led by essentially by Stuart Lindsay, who's here today as well. I'm going to be reading some notes he's given to me. Our application was filed on Monday in the Supreme Court. All right. I want to tell you a funny story. The computer system wasn't able to accept our application. How funny is that? I guess they don't get a JR every day, do they? It's not funny. Yesterday, our application to order the governor to produce everything before him, her, when he, she extended the declaration of emergency, and our application to have Grantley Stevens hand over all the materials he relied on to make his mandatory vaccination directions for teachers and for nurses, thank you, and for childcare workers, came before the courts. It's called an interlocutory application. Forgive me for getting that wrong. The Crown did not resist. They, in fact, expedited the provision of the documents. We will have most of the documents by the 29th of December. Great. And it gets more exciting. Here we go. 19th of January. I think we might be having a little bit of a rally. On that day, it will be decided whether the evidence needs to be given or not. And it will determine whether it is heard before one judge or three. Who would be keen to come down to the court on the 19th and make some noise?
I'll be there.
I think the general word is, having a chat with Stuart in the last day or two, that's the 9th of January. 19th. Stuart is very happy. Who saw our solicitor, Loretta, on the telly last night? That's right, she stood before that pack of delightful media people that we call journalists.
I don't call them that!
Arsehole!
What would we call these people?
Arsehole!
Kabar!
So that's the voice we need, Rally. Just get it out here, alright? Yeah. He thinks there'll be some very, this is again some remarks from Stuart. He thinks there'll be some very interesting twists and turns very shortly. And he wants to assure we the people that the application has been given the best crack possible, alright? The best chance possible. Everything that can maximise our chance of success has been done. Let me tell you, Adelaide Freedom Rally, that the solicitor and the team have absolutely put it all in there, and we've got a very good chance at this. Now, speaking of, I know we're running a bit late today, and I apologise, I've gone too far myself, but I'm going to read something from the Tizer. Oh boy, here we go.
Keep going.
This is the title in the Tizer. Who actually buys the Tizer? I feel for you. We wasted money on that garbage.
Not me.
AFLW Crows premiership player Denny challenges SA COVID-19 rules, vaccine mandates in the Supreme Court. Just one person? I can tell you today, we've got four people who are challenging that. How about a proper title, Mr. Advertiser? But I want to go to straight, I'm not going to bore you with this this blurb that was put in here by the advertiser. I want to go straight to this one quote here. Are you ready for this? Have a listen. The group does not contest the efficacy of the vaccines. They actually said that. They actually said that we don't actually think that the vaccine efficacy is a problem. All right. So Stuart, thanks for giving me this. Let me just get some information here.
Everyone's extremely healthy, non-stop.
This is from the documents that the team has submitted, the statements of facts and contentions. This is actually what is in the court right now. The degree of reduction in risk reduces towards zero as soon as two to three months from the date of the second dose of vaccine. Do you think we're contesting it? You bet we are. All right. Make sure you get into the buckets if you can, guys. Put some money in there today. Support the initiative. We've got about 160, somewhere in that sort of figure in the fund right now. We need to get that closer to 200. If you can join us today in donating to that, join us on the website or come and speak to us. We'll point us on the way. Now, I'm very excited. She hasn't spoken. She does her introduction sometimes long, but she hasn't actually spoken as a speaker for a while. Can we get on our feet? Can we flag our flags and make some noise for Kathy?
Thank you. I don't know why I was excited. I've written about 73 different speeches and I've got no idea which one I'll land on. But that's just me. I thought I might, a lot of you have seen me and heard me and I get a bit sick of saying it, but I came here a long time ago to be someone who voluntarily supported people by providing information and acknowledging their right to choice around vaccines. And it goes back a long way. I actually started that in 1993, having made my own choice based on research. I towed the line on vaccines when I started, but I'd done a science degree with pharmacology and my eldest child had a reaction and that got me investigating. And this is a story which is familiar to many people and I don't want to bore you with it, except to say that back in the day when I had media, when media would give voice to someone, And I would always quote scientific research and also people's experiences and fundamentals, like, you know, if it's a flu, you know, why have a flu vaccine? How about when you're sick, you rest, etc.? How about natural immunity? How about, as I keep saying, the fact that this is not cold and flu season right now? No cold or flu virus is going to spread anywhere in this kind of environment. So rather than bang on about my history, and you can see some of my lectures up on the website. I gave one in 2009, which, if you just change the date, we're in the same situation, except they didn't go quite this far. But when the media would ask me, you know, if I was an anti-vaxxer, I would say, look, personally, I wouldn't touch a vaccine with a barge pole, but it's not my place to tell anybody else what to do. So I just wanted to say to everybody today that when they call you an anti-vaxxer, I find that offensive because I'm the anti-vaxxer.
Yes.
You know, it's my title. I earned it. So just to defer your family and friends who are making some sort of judgment, go, no, you must mean cat. All right, I'm happy for it to land on my shoulders. There are a number of reasons why historically I guess it's worth me saying something, and that is because I've monitored this situation through the research and the media and the communication around the whole vaccine issue for decades, literally. And watched with great amusement while the pharmaceutical giants tried desperately to establish an adult vaccine market. And they just couldn't. Nobody was uptaking it. They managed to get it in for kids. They got across the line, you know, some really drastic measures, like giving kids hepatitis B vaccine at birth when they're at zero risk, when they don't get any long-term protection, and they can't now go to childcare or kindergarten without fully complying with the whole vaccine schedule. So Hep B is a disease of the intravenous drug-using population. And so they're not at risk, there is no long-term protection, but we do live in a world where as of 2015 people were penalised if they didn't hand over their baby at birth for a hepatitis B vaccine. So this is significant because in introducing this measure, which meant that these babies wouldn't know a single day without having poison injected, they describe babies as being captive, right? Captive. This is the language of the Australian government. So when stuff is happening like it is today, it just doesn't surprise me because I've seen it. And I've seen it happening for decades. I mean, the first thing that happened when they started vaccinating babies at birth was that they weren't establishing breastfeeding. And just like today, people went, oh, hello, that's not good. That's not great. That's a terrible outcome. How about we let these parents, these nurses in Queensland, know the risks and benefits, and then they can make their own decision. And of course, as soon as they did that, they were discredited and squashed and no longer able to speak. So it all sounds terribly familiar, doesn't it? Yeah? I just want to say, so obviously I'm public and I always have been, and I've never shied away from it, but it hasn't actually affected my adult relationships amongst family and friends until now. So until now, and that is because they've come for the adults and they've succeeded. And so much like this whole history of this us and them on the whole vaccine issue, now it's moved into the adult sphere. It's adults who feel very, very quick and free to judge anybody who's not doing what they're doing. So understand that, you know, understanding that context, if it's helpful at all to you, but what we have to really do right now, which we haven't achieved over the whole childhood vaccination schedule and mandates, what we have to achieve now is unity. We've got to find a way to all be on the same page. Obviously, everything that you say to challenge anything can be met, you know, hostily, with hostile, can't think of a word, but you know what I mean? Reacted to. And, you know, you go away and you feel bad when somebody has had a go at you for your choice, do you? You feel impacted by that. You feel impacted when the media the government, which they have done and they do freely do, is just judge you, dismiss you, actually name called discredit, never mind take away your livelihood, but also take away your family and your relationships. They feel very, very free and easy to just take away your rights, your relationships, your dignity. So there's a couple of rules. One is do not enter into an argument. Just back away. You don't need to take people on who are clearly going to suck the very life out of you because they disagree completely with what you're doing. You don't need to take them on. I've got one fan over here. Thanks. Everyone else is just getting hot. Okay? And you do need to reach out and get support amongst like-minded people so that you can be, you can get some perspective that you're not alone. And that's always been the case. It's the case with domestic violence, which is this is just a version of. Once you have that connection and community, then you're not alone, and you can be feeling supported, and you can reach out, and you can be involved. But don't ever take on somebody who's being angry at you. Just put it back on them. Why are you so angry about this? So we do have over to my right the epidemic, stop the epidemic of prejudice. These are the chippers. And they've got a very, very well thought out plan to support people who are impacted by hostility. By hostility in the media particularly. And that hostility in the media obviously fuels that hostility in amongst your family. Okay, it gives them the right, as does the government, as does everything uttered by ScoMo. It just gives people the right to be self-righteous and judge you. And it does impact and it isolates. And a lot of people are really particularly going to be affected by this at Christmas. But personally, I've been affected the whole time. And it baffles me because I've been a very public figure and it's never been like this before. But it's because they've come for the adults. They've finally got their adult vaccine market. So, calm and reasonable conversations. Seek support from good people. They're looking for volunteers over here or stories as well. And we'll be looking for stories from people as well later. My job has never been, you started as a researcher, but now it is to connect people. So please, I just encourage you all to reach out. Right. When you understand that parents have had no choice around vaccinating their children, perhaps you see that this is actually going to be a big task to have them differentiate between the COVID jabs and the other childhood vaccines. Because we know there's a guy called Mike. Mike's spoken at our rally. He's got some handouts. But you know, we know that these are devastating effects, particularly on fertility, and the reports are coming in of young girls, because we've already done that 12 plus age group, and people being reported already as having lost fertility. So, you know, it is devastating. We've got to pull out all stops right now, because the kids, the 5 to 12 year olds, are coming for us of Jan 10. So we need to find ways to have those conversations calmly with our families, support people with information, and this will be a really big drive through our community between now and January 10. So on a happier note, though, Layla is busy connecting people with other people. I want you to come up and just... So she went down really well last Sunday, so she's just going to have a quick note. Elizabeth Hart, if you're here, wanted to say something.
What about the one that goes into the ears?
Hello everyone, it's so good to see you all. My name is Layla, you might have seen me around, I spoke for the first time last week at the rally. My mum and I, we have started a matchmaking service. Vaccine free, just a gold coin donation. We've had overwhelming interest. We just want to connect people. So you can come and find me. I will be standing just to the right of the stage, if you're looking at the stage, on the gravel with my good friend Agnes in the overalls and the bucket hat holding her sign up. I've got plenty of application forms And if you don't get to me today, you can email me. We are Organic Love Pro-Choice Matchmaking, so organiclovepcm@hotmail.com.
Thanks, Taylor. It is the part is going to have a quick word, then we're going to finish up with Graham Lyons and get on to it. Thank God for public liability insurance. Some of you would have seen I did a quick live from the Royal Adelaide Hospital yesterday and actually attracted security, but they've got their special COVID care clinic and there's nobody in it. And there's security guards that coming at the end like, you cannot film here, you cannot. And I said, look, I just want to put people's minds at rest. There's been no activity in this clinic at all. There's no one in there. They've even dimmed the lights. One of the nurses actually just unsolicited did a happy dance inside the clinic. But there were no cars, there's no cases, there's nothing going on there. So I just said, look, I'm just doing this to reassure people that there's actually nothing going on. We can all go out, we can go be free and have fun because, you know, there's nothing spreading here, people.
There's nothing happening.
Hello everybody, I'm just giving you a little bit of an update on some things today. And I really want to say thank you to Bruce Pay, Dr. Bruce Pay, because the reason we're in so much trouble is because so few doctors are speaking out about this. In fact, so many doctors are bullying people into having these injections. They're not getting informed consent from people. People are not giving voluntary informed consent. They've been forced into having these injections to keep their jobs. And we know in a few days there's going to be discrimination imposed and that people who are uninjected, who made the informed decision not to have these defective injections, are going to be discriminated against because they're not going to be allowed into restaurants, we're being banned from sports clubs, golf clubs are banning us, I've been banned from my golf club. Yeah, I mean, that's minor compared to people, you know, losing their jobs. But this is absolutely major what is going on. The doctors are not getting informed consent. And I think this is going to blow sky high. This is a major, major issue. And, you know, people really need to start fighting back about this. And speaking of doctors, there's a very well-known doctor in our midst, and that's Nicola Spurrier. And I was... And today, somebody alerted me to an article in the Advertiser. I'm really surprised to see. It's titled 66 Staff Given Vax Exemptions. So this is very interesting. Some people are getting exemptions. So many people want exemptions, but they're not being granted exemptions. Only some people are. But what is going on here? This should not be happening. I mean, none of us should have to be fighting for exemptions. We should be just making our own informed decision about having these injections. So this has to be looked into. You know, why are some people getting exemptions and others are being forced to have these for their job? A dear friend of mine, next week, she's had to succumb and submit to having the injection to keep her job. She doesn't want to have this injection. She really doesn't want to have this injection, but she's going to be forced to have it because it's her livelihood. She's got children. It's just a desperate situation and it should not be happening. We've got the premiers, the prime minister, Scott Morrison, the police commissioners. You know, Grant Stevens has signed off on these mandates. What does he think he's doing? All these teachers and medical people, transport workers, they all have to have these injections because he's signed off on this. Why are they setting these mandates in place for against a disease that isn't a problem for most people? This should not be happening. Why are they doing it? A TAGI, which is a committee that makes the recommendations on these injections, they are backing off on this. They're saying they didn't make the mandates. So what is going on? Why are these premiers and chief health officers making these mandates and interfering with people's own health care decisions? They're supposed to be able to be voluntary decisions. Scott Morrison locked us into this country last year based on that Doherty modelling and he captured us as a market for these injections. They set us up for two doses and now there's a third dose booster and there's going to be many, many more. It has to stop. It just has to stop. And we have to challenge Morrison because these people are all traitors. They have betrayed us. What is the basis of this emergency? They will not answer. These governments are not accountable. They are illegitimate. They are not responsible. belongings to the people. We've been disenfranchised, and we have to fight back on this now. And I want to just bring you up to speed with a very interesting development in the UK. This is important because the UK is very much a part of what's going on. You all know about Neil Ferguson and his report out of Imperial College London that sort of put us into lockdown until the vaccine is ready. So he has influenced so many countries around the world. The UK is a major part of this. AstraZeneca vaccine got off the ground in the UK. How did that happen? How did the Ethics Committee approve those trials in people, healthy people who weren't at risk of the disease? Why are they having trials in healthy people? This whole thing stinks to high heaven. They've been creating a massive global injection market. Repeat injections, they are exploiting the whole world. And they have got to be brought to account. And just recently, the last couple of days, in the UK Parliament, on the back of the Omicron scare, have approved vaccine passports and compulsory vaccination for the NHS and wearing masks in them. That sounds pretty bad news, but it's actually a bit of a silver lining here, because 100 Conservative members voted against the vaccine passports. This is a major event. Even though it got through, it only got through with the support of Labour. So this is a major loss for Boris Johnson, because 100 Conservatives voted against the vaccine passports. And we know the vaccine passports are extremely dangerous because they're going to lead to a social credit system, and we're going to be controlled within each of our lives. You know, they already tell us when to stay in our homes and to put on masks and what have you. You've got to fight back on that now. But this is very important because another party, the Liberal Democrats, they also voted against these passports. And there's recently been a by-election in the UK in a seat which has been held by the Conservatives for over 200 years, nearly 200 years. They have lost that seat and it has gone to the Liberal Democrats. This is very important. Boris Johnson's leadership is now well under threat. We've got to see what happens on this next year. But vaccine passports are right out there, and you've got to get with the program and fight these, because they're trying to put the masks now with this discrimination that's been set up against the critically thinking uninjected who will not have these rubbish injections. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Just listen to their own language. I've heard at least three times on news bulletins in the last few days that their fear-mongering around the Omicron-Moronic strain is bolstering booster dose take-up. So, you know, it's a very obvious agenda of keeping people in fear. And also, you know, they've taken away so many freedoms, and then they give them back a little bit by a little bit, but they also come with conditions that remove other freedoms. So, you know, just use their own words, open your eyes, let's hope some people actually wake up. Graham Lyons is another reprobate. In fact, he's so non-compliant that he's not even approaching the stage, even though I've said his name loudly to several thousand people. So, Hopefully some form of penny might drop. He's too busy being an international superstar, I believe. But this man is he's the original reprobate. Everyone's been a little bit more than what we expected. Graham will speak, and then Alan will talk us through the letter writing that will take place after the march. Ladies and gentlemen, Graham Lyons.
Thank you, Kathy. Here's my early Christmas present, The Real Anthony Fauci by Robert Kennedy Jr. I've been so bloody busy lately, I haven't even had time to look inside it, but I've heard it's tremendous,
and I can
greatly recommend it. So I look forward to that over Christmas, New Year for my reading. For those who don't know me, I'm a scientist and a cattleman. My scientific work has revolved around providing micronutrients to populations who are deficient in them via their food systems. And I've been breeding cattle since 1962. So I know bullshit when I see it.
Yeah, good on you.
COVID-19, or as I call it, COVID-1984, is the greatest pile of bullshit ever dumped on humanity. Anyone who's heard me speak before will know that my major theme is one of non-compliance to all of the unlawful, unconstitutional, unhealthy, unscientific, idiotic tic-tacs emanating from that Orwellian, ironically named outfit on Hindmarsh Square, known as SA Health. And I do not comply with any of them.
Crack.
And I urge you to do likewise. It can be uncomfortable, you can imagine, when you're challenged for not wearing a face nappy. It takes a little bit of courage, but you can look at yourself in the mirror at the end of the day and not be ashamed of who you see. You might even be proud of that person. Okay, if you think I'm tough when it comes to non-compliance, you should see my great friend and legal advisor, Stuart Lindsay, who we've heard about already, in action. You should see him. He makes me look like a wimp. And
you're not a wimp, Graham.
And he is the most muscular Christian soldier you would ever meet. So I recommend him greatly.
He's a fellow Scot, too.
True, he's a fellow Scot. There you are, as am I.
Yes, good on
by
you,
way of Northern Ireland. Look at some of the people coming out of Northern Ireland. Van Morrison, for a start. Another very good Christian soldier. I'm meant to keep this pretty short, so I'd better keep moving. My most notable act of non-compliance to date has been to refuse the so-called, as I call it, nasal rape, where they shove a bloody poison swab up your nose, close to your brain, sampling your DNA without your consent, probably poisoning you in the process, and that then leads to the fake, fraudulent, so-called PCR COVID test, which does not test for free infectious viruses or any other viruses at all, as repeatedly told by its inventor, Carrie Mullis. And yet that is what has been used as the underpinning of this entire COVID 1984 house of cards. Those so-called cases and infections are nothing of the sort. They are false positives to a fake test.
Yes.
So what are they doing with them? No, they're shutting people in their houses. They're closing borders.
What do we want to be the whole, vegetarian for?
The whole fraudulent thing is based on that dub test. So that's why I do not bow down to it. And that's landed me in court twice now. And this goes back to the end of March this year. My most recent court appearance was 2 days ago. Thank you very much to my... my small band of supporters who are there, and the latest word is it's been adjourned until March the 3rd. It's been kicked down the road again, the can's been kicked down, and the police haven't actually answered the questions that we put to them over their procedural methodology, the flaws in. I'll move on to something else. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it takes a bit of getting your head around the fact that our governments, state and federal, are trying to kill us.
Yes.
Yeah. And we need to respond accordingly. This is a war. They are actually trying to fucking kill us. And so don't think that that's extreme. That's what they're bloody doing. And now they're rolling out their bloody quacks. I call it a quacks, it's not a vax. Quacks better illustrates the quackery, the pseudoscience used by the bastards promoting it to try and sell this bloody thing. They're trying to ram it into our 5 to 11 year olds. Next year we'll be coming for the 2 to 4 year olds. This is nothing more nor less than satanic child abuse. That's what it is. And so what do we think of those bastards who are promoting this? What about the chief public health officer? What a ripper she is. The premier, the police commissioner. They are presiding over satanic child abuse. I'll never forget that. And it's going to get worse before it gets better, but it will get better because we will beat them. Well, I had the great privilege this morning. I haven't had much sleep tonight. That's why I haven't committed this all to memory. I apologise. I spent an hour with the great Ryan of Fuel Mick this morning. It was a great privilege for someone like me to be invited onto his program in Berlin via Zoom. What a great bloke he is. And if you think what he's doing, he is continuing to try to hold these people to account, his bastards behind this agenda, those people who like to remain in the shadows. They put forward their front gophers like Gates, Fauci, Soros, Schwab. They're the ones we see, but there are even more people behind the scenes. We need to sell them back, send them under their rocks where they came from, back into the shadows. This is what we're dealing with. Now, I probably need to wind up here. One thing that Brian has said to me in particular was, after I mentioned what Ricardo Bosi from Australia One has been up to, he said, I want to correspond with this guy. So, yes, Ricardo, so if Sharon and Kevin are here, I dare say they are, I've got an email, yes, there they are, an email that you can use to reach Ryan for me. So come and see me afterwards. Also, for those who haven't seen my 13 reasons not to take the quacks, which I've been sending out around the world since January, some people have taken notice of it. A lot of people haven't, and that dismays me, because I've got a pretty good track record in my truth-seeking ability as a scientist, and I've put more into this last 20 months than I have in the 22 years of normal scientific activity before that. If you haven't seen it, so come and see me. I've got some copies here. And, to conclude, you won't be seeing me inside the Adelaide Oval this year. It's become a quacks trap. You know what I mean by that? You've got to show your double vaccination app or a certificate to get in the bloody gate. What a disgrace. The zoo is the same. It's a quacks trap. There are certain businesses around their place putting up their stupid hands to make themselves into quack straps. What about Bird in the Hand Winery? That was the first one to do it. So we all know where not to go. We've also got some good businesses on our good business list. So you won't be seeing me at Adelaide Oval except perhaps to protest outside the gates. And they're those hapless individuals who actually go in who've been quacks. They're made to sit there throughout the entire performance with their bloody face nappies on. How pathetic is that? I'm getting the stare. Okay, so thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
I like that.
Hold the line.
Good on you, mate. I like this guy.
Thanks, Captain Stare. Hey, we're running behind, but how fantastic was that? How fantastic was Graham Lyons and Elizabeth Hart before him? They're fantastic people. So passionate, so prolific in their letter writing, in their campaigning. Absolutely brilliant. So we've just got Alan to talk us through this letter writing. Now people just went, what are we going to go to the park and write letters? I tell you what, we are very, very keen to collect simple stories of vaccine damage and death. All right? There is no correlation or honest reporting happening through government agencies. I sat outside yesterday while the judicial review hearing took place, and I spoke to the ABC journalist, and he thought mandates only affected government employees. A journalist. Only government employees. Well, they affect a lot more than that, including our police, and who will be hopefully taking off their masks in this heat today. The death and destruction from this vaccine is what needs to be documented. There's a sign over here, my best friend's mum died after the second jab. Right, we all know someone who is no longer with us. We all know someone who has been incredibly disabled by these experimental jabs, which are in a trial phase still for safety. So it is absolute genocide. Here's Alan to explain the process, and then I'll give you some info on that.
Hi, everyone. I know you're all itching to get marching. I'll be very brief. In 23 days, they begin injecting our 5-year-old children.
Boo! Boo!
My kids are safe, your kids are safe, but millions of kids are not. If you want to be part of the solution, please visit parentswithquestions.com.au. Yeah. This is a new resource that provides tools to help initiate conversations and get parents talking. It's so important. Be your own hero. Encourage as many as you can to look at this site. You can download the flyers and do letter drops in your own neighborhoods. 1,000 flyers have been distributed out here today, so please take one home and drop it in your neighbor's mailbox tomorrow morning. The line has been drawn. Too many other lines have been crossed. And are we going to remain silent and allow this to happen to our kids?
No! No!
Voices for Choices. Life is another great initiative that is made up of sports stars and celebrities worldwide. They include former world champion Kelly Slater, Barton Lynch, Taj Burrow, Lane Beachley, Kane Johnson, Trevor Hendy, Tora Bright, Andrew Bogut, and John Ferris. All of them stand with us. And now the SANFL has mandated this experiment. My father-in-law is the late, great Don Lindner. And I tell you what, Donnie would not approve of this. So if you know anyone who's someone who plays and is not happy with them, please tell them to go to SAIF.cloud. We've set up an email there so they can send in their details. Because I am sick of hearing of healthy young people having to decide if putting food on the table and participating in society is worth risking this procedure. Show of hands, how many people here today know someone who's been suffered an injury after the injection? Right. So all of you may be wondering why we asked you to bring paper and envelopes. This idea came to me from a man named Peter. We believe there are members of the media who are good people. We want to bring to their attention that many are suffering from these injuries. We want to open up honest conversations. The silence on this issue must end. Where has the compassion for our fellow citizens gone? Why is COVID cases get endless media attention and vaccine injuries are rarely reported or discussed? I know many people who are injured. And if you do not have a story to tell of an injured person, then an alternative would be to write about some medical discrimination I know a lot of people are experiencing now. So the ABC is a national news body, and its salaries come from us, the taxpayers. Its charter makes a very clear statement. The role of the ABC in Australia is to educate. That's what the charter says. Now today, we have information, not opinions, not beliefs, not anger, not theories. We have information that we are going to put to the ABC, and we're going to ask the ABC to do its job.
Yeah.
So we ask that each and every one of you here today take the time after the march and write a brief letter. It's imperative that you write this letter, and you write it from politeness and respectfulness. Being rude is only going to derail this exercise. It's very important, polite and respectful. There are camera people out in the crowd today, so if you have a story, please share it with them. We are honest people telling simple truth. We're not afraid to put our names to what we know is true. One story, one letter. Two stories, two letters. This is unprecedented, and we hope it will open the door for conversations in the broader public. And I'll just read you one example of my letter. Dear Sonia Feldoff, my friend Amy is 21 years old. Under duress, she succumbed to the pressure to keep her job and was vaccinated on November 1st. She has had migraine headaches for 47 days. The lymph nodes on her neck, behind her ear, armpit, and groin have been swollen and sore. The doctors have had nothing to offer this poor girl apart from painkillers. She is distressed and her life has been flipped on end. If you would like to speak to Amy, please contact me, signed Alan, and I leave my contact details. So please, return to the park today and complete this task. Get into groups of 15 to 20. There's volunteers out there today with their red Santa hats on, and they'll be able to assist you with any questions you might have. Ensure that photo evidence is taken prior to sealing the envelopes is the only other thing I'll ask you. And if you can take that time to return to the park and write those letters, I'll be standing over there behind Matt's signs down the street, and we'll collect all those letters, and we're gonna hopefully send thousands of letters into the ABC over the course of this week. So I thank you, Adelaide, and I know these are really hard times, but I wish you all a Merry Christmas and God bless.
Thank you. Are we going for a walk?
Yeah. Right, thanks.
We're done for a walk.
Thanks, Alan. So that is the goal for when we get back to the park. You've been given instruction and a heads up for days now. The other thing that can happen when we get back to the park is if you are in need of some assistance to help you through Christmas, you can go to the Safe Guardians SA trailers over here where people have made generous donations, please. So that will happen. Now, it's warm. I want everyone to stay safe on this march. We will do, you voted before to go all the way to King William Street.
We're about to go for a march.
Yes.
It's going to be a long one.
Right, so make sure you've got water on you. Make sure that you rest if you need, or cut through a side street and maybe not go so far if you are starting to get a bit warm. We had this happen last Sunday where people got a little bit too warm. So it's the usual procedure, as in we go up to the corner here, the North Terrace corner of the park, where we will assemble and then we will take to the streets in our beautiful large numbers. I want to thank all of you, each and every one of you, for coming out today.
Make sure it's
despite all the fear-mongering and scare-mongering, which of course we do not participate in, we do not engage with, we don't give it oxygen because we are far too smart and beautiful and connected and caring about ourselves and our well-being to give oxygen to anyone who you know, is a disruptor or full of vitriol. We don't like. We're not compliant. All right, see you up at the corner.
Yeah, go for it, mate.
Hiya, mate.
How you going? Good, good.
I'll do this march, but I don't know how long I'm going to go.
Hey, where's the social distancing? Crap. It's all crap. It's all crap. Brothers of prayers, and it's against jabbing against all, and even mine. We're going for a long march up to King William Street. Can I have a look at the sign, thanks? Yes, we got it. Yes.
You're
going to follow me, or where are you going?
Can you turn around? That's the real
this is good.
Okay, we'll find him. Meet him at the front.
We should do it.
One more.
Ange, would you like to say something, Angela? Yes. A successful march. No jab, no work. That's disgusting. Blackmail. Yeah. my body, my choice. Man, what are the guys wearing their masks for? Why are your cops wearing their masks? Is something wrong with you? Did you hear what I yelled out to the cops?
No, no, idiots.
Watch out, you don't get malaria without a mask.
Welcome to the
You're doing a good job, but a mask is not really necessary, is it? I mean, look after your health. Have a good Christmas.
We will not comply!
We will not comply!
any of those mainstream media muppets are watching.
Tell the truth! 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 Tell the truth!
Think it's time for a bit of a sing song. Let's get this going, get your vocal cords ready.
Do you
like
me?
You can shove your vaccine mandates up your ass.
Up your ass!
You
up
can shove your vaccine mandates up your ass!
Up your ass!
You can shove your vaccine mandates
up your ass!
You tell them!
Shove your vaccine mandates up your ass!
One more time! You can shove your vaccine mandates up your ass! Up your ass!
Shove your vaccine mandates up your ass!
Everyone!
Yes!
Yeah.
Shove your vaccine mandates! Shove your vaccine mandates up your ass!
You can shove your COVID vaccine up your ass!
It's all bullshit!
You can shove your COVID vaccine up your ass!
Everyone!
You can shove your COVID vaccine! Shove your COVID vaccine up your ass!
Your ass!
Stoccolo! In Greek, Stoccolo!
Stoccolo up your Stoccolo!
Alright, we're gonna get this loud, just so everyone knows where we're from and who we represent.
Aussie, Aussie, Aussie!
Oi, oi, oi!
Aussie, Aussie, Aussie!
Oi, oi, oi!
Aussie!
Oi!
Aussie!
Oi!
Aussie, Aussie, Aussie!
Oi, oi, oi!
Let's get this loud, we need to make this clear!
What do we want?
Whoa, good crowd, boy, guys. You're seen all over the world.
I've never done it before. You want me to?
Yeah, come on.
Oh, no.
He's coming.
That's it. My body, my choice.
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 My body, my choice! My body, my choice!
We have a corrupt government!
My body, my choice!
What do we want?
Freedom!
Where do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Freedom!
Where do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Freedom!
Where do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Freedom!
Where do we want it?
Now!
Who don't we want them to touch?
My body, my choice!
My body, my choice!
Freedom!
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 my body, my choice.
Aussie, Aussie, Aussie! Aussie, Aussie, Aussie! Aussie, Aussie, Aussie! Woo! Okay, guys! That is all and every single one of you guys. Who do you want them to touch?
Never go on. Come on.
Who do you want them to touch? Who do you want them to touch?
I'm getting everything.
Who do you want them to touch?
Stop.
Who do you want them to touch?
Why are you wearing a mask for? They're unhealthy.
Bring it up to this line here, guys.
Freedom!
the street, people. We're gonna make the streets of Adelaide hear this. The people of Adelaide need to hear this. What do we want?
Freedom!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Freedom!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Freedom!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Freedom!
When do we want it?
Now!
Take back Australia!
Whoa!
It's not a vaccine!
It's not a vaccine!
Yeah.
It
helps us.
It does.
Have you got it?
Have you got your vaccine?
Yeah.
Good. Then fuck off. Who cares? That's what your vaccine protects you. It protects you then. Right? No one else.
Hey, you can still get the virus. Hey, you can still get the virus with a vaccine.
Wait, she's a crackhead. Look at my tummy.
You can still get the flu with the flu vaccine.
Hey,
no, that's a flu vaccine as well.
Guys, we're just gonna stop here. Guys, hold it.
Bullshit, personally.
Well, my friend nearly died.
Yeah, I think it's a joke. You're going to die from any vaccination, let's be real.
No, well, he...
I can argue all day.
He regretted it, he nearly died.
Yeah, but look, anyone's going to die from any vaccination, aren't they?
Look, it affects some people, it doesn't.
No, but what vaccination? You're not going to have side effects.
Everybody come on.
I don't believe it.
Okay,
I've
had like six of you heard me. Let's give that another go. What do we want?
Freedom!
What do we want? It?
Yeah!
What do we want? When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Freedom!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Freedom!
When do we want it?
Now!
My body, my choice!
My body, my choice!
My body, my choice!
My body, my choice!
My body, my choice.
You're right there.
My body, my choice.
Right, young and healthy. Hey, say it again.
I'm fine, young and healthy, as you can see.
My
no vaccine, nothing.
And your immune system is strong.
That's it.
Very strong.
I like your tattoo.
Thank you very much, mate. That's why I read you come up and did this and said, yeah, mate. Look at that.
Mate, that's all you need, mate.
That's all right.
We wear cross-field protection.
Yeah, that's right.
See, I've got one here.
Yeah? I've got my pendant at home. Just in case days like this.
What nationality are you?
I'm national, I'm Italian.
Italiano, you're sort of correct.
You're going to get out, I know you're telling me.
Oh, yeah,
very soon.
You've done really well.
Yeah,
you should really appreciate what you've done.
Before.
Yeah. We're not done yet. There's more work to be done. It's so on the whole, fucking city to hear this.
Again, louder. Our bodies, our choice. Our bodies, our choice.
That's sounding better. Our bodies, our choice.
Our bodies, our choice.
My body, my choice.
My body, my choice.
Your body, your choice.
Your body, your choice.
When do we want it? What do we want? When do we want it? What do we want?
Freedom!
What do we want?
Freedom!
Do you sell the water? How much is a bottle of water?
It's a bit warm.
How much is a bottle of water?
Yeah, never, man.
Thank you, mate. Cheers. Yeah. Ooh. I wouldn't touch him. I wouldn't touch him. Let fuck him. Get that. Beautiful. Cheers.
Cheers.
I love the sign.
Thank you.
George, how you going?
How's it going?
Not bad, thanks. A bit tired going around, mate, for an old man. I got it all, though.
Yeah, I saw you running around.